Hey, science explorers, it's Justin again. Last time we explored a cold desert, which was quite an adventure, wasn't it? Today, we're in a place that's also cold, but a little different from a cold desert. Can you guess where we are? This is the tundra. There's no snow right now, but it's very cold here. Even though it's really cold, the tundra is full of life. And today, we're going to discover what makes the tundra so unique. All right, so we're in the tundra. But what is a tundra exactly? Well, a tundra is a very cold and treeless biome. Winters here are long and freezing, and summers are short and usually still a little chilly. While there's no snow on the ground right now, underneath the soil, the ground is frozen all year long. There's a word for that. What was it, Mia? Oh, right, permafrost. Yeah, it's just a layer of ice not far underneath the ground. How crazy is that? Even though it's freezing here, there are still small plants like moss and tiny shrubs all over, but absolutely no trees. The permafrost makes it hard for large plants to dig their roots deep into the ground. Tundras are found in the northernmost part of North America, Europe, and Asia. They're mostly located near the Arctic Circle and on high mountains. The Arctic Circle is an imaginary line, kind of like the equator, that goes around the top part of the Earth near the North Pole. It's super cold up here all year round. Right now, we're in Alaska. This area has beautiful scenery, and it's nothing but tundra. Being here kind of reminds me of when we were exploring in the cold desert, but even though both places are cold, they have some big differences. It's not a lot, but tundras have more plant life. These plants stay close to the ground to avoid the cold winds. Cold deserts have fewer plants because they're very dry. You might see some small bushes, but not much else. There's also more water in tundras, even though it's frozen most of the year. Both tundras and cold deserts have extreme temperatures. It can get very cold in both places, especially in winter. But tundras can be a bit warmer in summer, while cold deserts stay extremely cold all year round. In the tundra, it can be dark all day and night in winter, but in summer, the sun can shine all day and night. Cold deserts also have long winters, but they get more sunlight during the year compared to tundras. Wow, the weather and landscape change a lot here, with different amounts of sunlight and a big shift from summer to winter. I wonder what the plants and animals do to keep up with all of these changes. Let's look around and see if we can find out. Look at this moss. Mosses are great at holding onto water and staying green, even in freezing temperatures. They grow close to the ground, which helps them stay warm, because the ground temperatures are warmer than those higher up. It also shields the plants from strong and freezing winds. Earlier, Mia and I were exploring, and we saw this plant. It's called the Arctic willow. It looks so different. What is all over it? Is that hair? I've never seen a plant with hair before. Why do you think it's developed that trait? Well, that hair must keep it warm in this harsh, cold environment. Oh, whoa, look at this Arctic fox. Look how its fur is the exact same color as the rocks. Great camouflage. But that wouldn't work when it snows, right? Its fur would need to be white. Oh, look! In winter, it's white to blend in with the snow. And in summer, it turns brown or gray to blend in with the rocks and plants. That fur looks very thick, too. It has to be to keep it warm here. Ooh, and these are caribou. They have thick fur and a layer of fat to keep warm. Hey, kind of like the animals in the cold desert that have blubber. Caribou also have special hooves that help them walk on the snow and dig for food under ice. They've adapted quite a bit to be able to live here. Birds live here too, like this snowy owl that's a great hunter. It uses its sharp eyes to find food even in the snow. And the willow ptarmigan. Huh, usually birds have scaly feet, but this one has feathers that go all the way down to its talons. Why do you think that is? And its color is very similar to the Arctic fox's. Do you think it changes colors with the seasons too? Look at that! I guess it does! Wow, plants and animals in the tundra have some amazing adaptations. Thick fur, special hooves, changing colors, and growing close to the ground are just some ways they survive in this icy world. Oh wait, here's another caribou. What's it eating? Looks like he's eating the plants. I wonder if all of the animals here eat plants. Next time, we'll investigate who eats what in this chilly biome. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers!